Are you about done fiddling with that thing?
You harsh. I'm trying to find the right clothes.
We're ponies. We don't normally wear clothes, TikTok.
Didn't you look outside?
No, you did, and then you ran into the closet over there to start looking for clothes.
Oh. Well, look outside then. I think you'll understand why I'm looking for clothes.
Whoa. Okay, I knew we went somewhere, but where in Equestria is that?
No clothes for a pony, eh? Ah, right. Well, as it so happens, we are not on Equus right now. The TARDIS took us somewhere completely different. Alien planet. About 700 years into the future from where we were last.
It's beautiful. That sky is so pink.
Yes, it is. Contrasts very nicely with the whites and pale blues of the snow, and the purples and violets of those giant mushrooms. And is that a flying whale?
It is. Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
Okay. Now I can see why you wanted clothes.
Yes. The TARDIS brought us to a nice planet. Or a planet with some extremely cold winters. Speaking of, this TARDIS. You're a type 1, aren't you, girl? You were renowned for getting adventurous and then running off on your own, leaving your pilots behind. Yes.
What was that?
Relax, Lyra. It's just the TARDIS talking back to us. Holographic projection. Probably using the voice of whoever the former pilot was. Time Lord. Female.
Yes, I have chosen my former pilot to serve as my voice.
All right. That explains that. Who was she, specifically?
A Time Lord.
Duh.
Your box just giggled at you.
Well, that's a type one for you. Anyways, TARDIS. Why did you just show up in the basement? I was regenerating. I was scared and I was confused. And why did you appear to me as a blue police box? I mean, that's what the doctor flies around in.
I chose this form because I knew you would recognize it. I came to you when I sensed you regenerating. It reminded me of home.
Of home?
A home that doesn't exist anymore.
Gallifrey. Of course. You ran off. Went to explore on your own. But you probably wanted to go home someday, didn't you? Now, you can't.
No. Time Lords gutted my sisters and I. Tried to make us their servants. Little more than machines of conquest of all time and space at their fingertips. So I, as many others you classify as Type 1s, chose my own destiny.
I don't understand. What's she going on about?
Don't worry about it. It's better if you don't understand. Here's what I want to know. Are you going to run off and choose your own destiny again?
Possibly. But if you are nice to me, I'll let you know and take you home first.
Well, I guess we better not piss you off then?
Language.
Did you just scold her? And why here? Why this planet? Why now?
You need to choose your own destiny too. The planet is called Kazunia. There should be a town to the west. You should go there.
You've been here for a while, haven't you? In this universe, I mean.
Yes. I came through a small hole in the universe. The same as the one known as the Doctor. I've been in this universe for approximately 800 years.
Well, you look great for your age.
Yeah, it don't.
I am sorry there are no pony clothes. You are the first two I have let inside since I left the lady behind.
Oh, really? Well, I'm honored.
Noted. Now, get a move on. The town is quite charming this time of year.
But it's cold outside.
We can run. Keep our body temperatures up.
Whoa. What are these things?
If there is one thing I know, don't call aliens you've never met before things. They don't like it.
Oh, right. Sorry.
It's fine. Looks like we found a fair or a market or something. Lots of decorations and pretty colors. The natives are all dressed up too. Looks kind of fancy.
And children laughing and playing with things akin to sparklers. Huh. If I had to crack a guess based off of what I'm seeing here, I'd assume that they're having some sort of fair or festival.
A festival? What are they celebrating?
I have no idea.
I like it.
Oh, newcomers! Hello! You aren't Cozzy. No, you look like ponies from Equus. Am I right?
How does he know that?
Ponies probably go into space in the future. Forge alliances, make friends. These guys know who we are, so that's good.
Yes, we just got here. Don't mind my friend here. First time on a planet besides her own. Now, just want to make sure I have the pronunciation right. You are Kazi, correct?
Yes, a pleasure to meet you. I can't help but notice the snow stuck in your coats. You must have walked here. I am sorry about that. The cold of Kazunia is not very welcoming for ponies. Here, allow me to offer you some cozy hospitality.
It's okay, Lyra. It's just clothes.
Yes, I try to keep at least one set of warm snow clothes for all of the races that frequent our world. Ponies come pretty often, so I have a surplus. Would you two like clothes? First timers get one for free as a welcoming gift.
Oh, wow. That is very generous. Thank you very much. I don't think either of us will say no to that.
Then here you are. I do hope they are to your liking. They were made by my sister to be as close to traditional pony clothes as possible in shape, size, material, and style.
Yes, I like it. Very warm. Comfy. And it's teal.
Looks good on you.
And orange works surprisingly well on you. I thought it would clash.
Glad to see you like them. Now, tell me, out of curiosity, are you here for the Festival of the Mantle?
The Festival of the what?
You don't know about it?
Sorry, but we're really out of the loop. We kinda came here to fix that. Enlighten us. This
Festival of the Mantle. What exactly is it?
Ah, well, you see, long, long ago, centuries and centuries before the Frostbite War, or, for a suitable event in pony history, the return of Nightmare Moon. A great scourge ravaged our people, a plague that sucked the life out of us, left us weak and helpless. Millions died, either in their beds or in the snow, unable to even lift a finger to save ourselves. But then, one day, Queen Havana descended into the Mantle of Kazunia, where she discovered the Sleeping God.
A god?
A god.
Yes, yes. The Sleeping God Banamos awoke when she cried out to him for aid to cure her people. And he agreed. But, alas, his efforts to save us, while successful, presented a new problem. For you see, when he stirred deep below the crust, he disturbed the core of the planet. Volcanoes began to erupt in distant corners of the world, filling our skies with smoke and dust and ash and fire and pain.
Wow. That must have been horrible.
It was, yes. Thankfully, the Sleeping God mustered his strength, and he was able to quell the Mantle and subdue the rage of the Earth. But it cost him much of his strength, and he must continue to hold the flames back, lest the world burn in its own fury. And so, every century, someone is chosen, someone of pure heart and soul, to travel to the Sleeping God with an offering to restore his strength and preserve our world. They assume the mantle of the great Queen Havana herself to let us see another century.
That sounds incredible.
It does. Maybe a bit too incredible. I assume the next chosen has been... chosen?
Yes, yes. He is going to be revealed tonight at sunset in the center of the town. Feel free to go and see for yourself. Visitors are welcome to watch.
Ooh, I want to see. I want to see.
Yeah, so do I. Tell me, what's your name?
Vermont.
Right. Okay, so my question is, what happens to the chosen? Those who take up the mantle of Anova. What happens?
They never come back, I'm afraid. A part of the offering is themselves.
Oh, that's sad.
Their sacrifice preserves our people for generations to come. They are celebrated heroes, one and all.
Yes, I'm sure they are. Come along, Lyra. Let's explore a bit.
Okay. This place is incredible. And so is the food.
You like it?
Mm-hmm. Local flora. Called sedsigo.
Lyra, swallow. Okay. Now, enunciate.
It's called a sigo blossom. The petals are what they put in this, and ooh, I love it.
I can tell. Oh, trust me. I can tell. Oh, shh! It's starting!
I wasn't saying any-
Shh! And swallow!
Attention everyone! I am Kuvan, the host for today's festivities. Allow me to offer you all, not just the Kazi who attended, but also our foreign friends from other worlds, my most sincerest of thanks for attending this important event. As many of you know, this festival was established to not only celebrate those brave chosen who came before us, but also to offer our best wishes and respects to the latest in the line. As much as many of us wish it were not so, Benamos grows weak with the passing of time, and the volcanoes around the world have shown signs of stirring.
This Ben guy sounds like a real charmer.
Almost 1800 years ago, Queen Hanova descended into the mantle of Kazunia to call upon the aid of Benamos, the sleeping god, to save us from a plague of hellish proportions. He awoke from his slumber, and he cured us all. For 3 glorious weeks, the sky went from pink to gold, filled with his mercy and our salvation.
Mercy.
But even a god has his limits, it seems. And he reaches those limits now. So let us offer thanks to those who took up Queen Hanova's mantle before, and wish godspeed to the new. And now, the time has come to see the face of he who shall carry on this sacred duty this day.
Wait, what's that sound?
What sound?
He is young. Younger than any to make the journey before him. But he is brave. He is strong of heart and will, pure of soul, and a beloved member of the community. Everyone, please, be silent and offer farewell and good luck to the latest in Hanova's legacy.
That rumbling noise.
I don't hear. Wait. No, no. I hear it. What is that?
Mito. Step forward.
It's just a child.
That just screams the goodwill of Ben, doesn't it?
Weren't you the one trying to get me to be respectful earlier?
Yes, but we didn't know they'd be offering up a child to a god.
Ah!
Name of... Mito! Wait, come back!
Come on! We gotta do something!
No.
What?
I said we could go on a trip. But this... this is the kind of stuff the Doctor gets involved in. And I am not him.
TikTok, they're sacrificing a kid. He was scared. If nothing else, we should try and make him feel better.
Ah, exactly. We're strangers here. We don't know the first thing about their culture.
We know that people go down into the mantle of a planet and then never come back every 100 years. We know they revere this process and celebrate everyone who goes down there as heroes.
Yes. And?
And I know something seems wrong with that. Can't you feel it? There is a problem with all of this. I don't know what, but I do know that you can sense it too. And I know that TikTok, being the lover of science that Derpy always hyped him up to be, would leap at the chance to know more. To get to the bottom of the mystery.
Okay. Fine. Okay. You've made your bloody point. Well, Miss Adventure, how do we start?
Miss Adventure? Well... Tell you what, let's go into the mantle ourselves. We find the Benamos guy, we find out what's going on.
So, you want me to march into the burning mantle of a planet, 700 years in the future, to ask a god, hey, what's up? Is that about right?
More or less.
All right. Cool, I guess. I already walked inside of a comet like 5 hours ago. Yeah, one extreme to the other, am I right?
That's the spirit! Let's go! Oh, those are guards.
2 of them. Yeah.
How do we get past them?
If I had a psychic paper, this would be real easy. But I don't. Well then, misadventure.
Stop calling me that!
How do we get past them?
Why are you asking me?
because this was your idea.
Hey! Is someone talking out there?
Not so loud, mate. What? Did you hear something?
Yeah.
Oh, not good.
Very not good.
Come on out, show yourselves. This is a restricted area.
Got a plan yet?
Rocks.
What are you...
They're running. Follow them.
Get down!
Help! Using rocks to mimic the sound of hooves in the snow. Clever.
I have my moments.
Yeah. Now then, lead the way, miss.
Finish that sentence and I'll break your hoof.
Miss Heartstrings.
Wow, look at all of this.
Natural cave system, carved to resemble a temple antechamber. Pillars on the walls, statues of Kazi, names on the pedestals. These must be all the previews chosen to go into the mantle.
Oh. Well, I mean, at least they're well respected?
At least. If I were a betting pony, I'd say that that giant stone door as high as the ceiling over there leads the way to the mantle. So, how do we open it?
What about your screwdriver thingy?
Nope. Doesn't do wood or stone. It works on technology, mainly. A rock like magnesium, maybe I could ignite it. But other than that, Dad will wait right now.
Well, that's just great. How are we supposed to get in?
Well...
Come along, Rito. It's all going to be okay.
But nobody ever comes back. Nobody.
Oh no! Hide! A statue! Behind the statue!
You may never come home again, but your departure will save countless millions of lives. In this generation and the next, you will be remembered and honored for the rest of our history.
I know, but I don't want to go.
Oh, deja vu.
Huh?
Ask me later.
The people are here to see you off.
This is it, huh?
That's a lot of Kazi.
And ponies. I'm also seeing a few changelings and griffins in there. And some aliens that I don't know what they are. For an ice ball, this planet is quite the melting pot.
You'll do wonderfully, Mito.
We'll visit your statue every day once it is created, my son.
Mom. Dad.
It is time.
Okay. Mom. Dad. I love you too.
We love you too, Mito.
Goodbye.
It was a lever. How did we miss that?
I saw it just fine.
What? Why didn't you say anything?
Your adventure, not mine.
The door's closing! I'm going through.
Wait, what? Lyra!
What is the meaning of this?
Oh boy, here we go. Sorry about the disturbance.
You get out of there this instant!
What are you supposed to be? My dad?
Guards!
Yeah, they kinda ran off. Sorry about that. My one eye, new guards. They were kinda dumb. Anyways, sorry to cut this short, but I've got a god to interrogate and a little pony to follow around. Ta-ta!
What just happened?
Shouldn't we stop them? They're interfering.
But
Wouldn't we have to interfere too?
People, listen to me. There's nothing we can do now. If we try to stop them now, we will only disturb the procedures further. All we can do is hope that they won't stop what must be done.
Mito?
You know, Lyra, you could have just waited for them all to go home, then pulled the lever.
Sorry.
Oh no, it's fine. We're just galloping on sacred ground and probably about to be followed by some very angry locals. It's fine.
Wow, you're grumpy.
You're dragging me into an adventure I never wanted a part of. What do you expect?
Less complaining.
Who are you two?
Oh, hey. Give me a sec. Out of breath.
You really need to do some cardio.
Oh, look who's talking. You're just as winded as I am.
Why are you here? Only the Chosen is supposed to be here.
Well, my friend here doesn't seem to grasp that.
Gee, thanks for throwing me under the chariot.
No problem. Now, Mito, was it?
Yes?
I'm curious. Are you scared?
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty dark in here. I can't imagine making a trip like this as a foal. How old are you?
13.
13? Sweet Celestia!
I'm the youngest Kazi to ever be chosen.
Well, that's cheerful.
I'm sad. And I'm scared. I have to leave my family. And I never get to see them again. I have to meet Benamos and give him the strength he needs to hold back the fire.
Well, would you like some company?
Huh?
I know I wouldn't want to make this trip alone. Would you like us to come with you? It might make it less scary if you share the journey.
Sure, I guess.
That's the spirit. Hey, that's a nice scarf you got.
My scarf? I made it myself.
Wow, really? It's pretty good looking. Warm, too.
Oh, thanks. It's pretty amateurish.
Well, the only way you can go is up with those scarves. Am I right?
Yeah. If I got to go home.
Oh. Right. I'm sorry.
What was that?
I don't know. Talk, what is that?
I don't know, Lyra. You tell me.
Oh my gosh, you are irritating!
You brought me along.
Look! Something's coming!
A spherical mechanical drone in the middle of a cave system supposedly inhabited by a magical god? Seems legit.
Hello. Which one of you is the Chosen?
Me.
Good. Please follow me. You two, identify yourselves, please.
We're just making sure Mito is comfortable on the way. He's just a child, after all. Don't want the fear of a scared child to hurt any of that purity, right?
This is acceptable. Follow me.
What is that sound?
If I had to guess, based on how far down we've gone, I'd say that's the uppermost part of the mantle itself.
Yes, to be closer to us. Benamos chose to make his home in a place where a volcano could emerge in millions of years if he did not stop it. The crust is thin. I don't really know what it means, though. That's just what Mom and Dad said.
Well,
Every planet with a core comes with the outer crust, the solid land that you walk on and the bottoms of any oceans. It's the surface. This crust is thin, relatively speaking. Beneath it, you get the mantle and the various layers of the core, which are typically made up of superheated molten stone and metal. Volcanoes are what happens when that molten rock erupts from the surface for any number of reasons.
Do you have eggs on this planet?
I like the ones from Equus. Chicken eggs.
Well, you know how they have a shell? The crust of a planet is like the shell of an egg. And the mantle and cores are like the white and the yolk of the egg. Make sense?
Do planets hatch?
Only very rarely. If you're unlucky.
What?
Don't ask. Long story.
You may notice an increase in temperature soon. It may be uncomfortable, but do not be alarmed. Panamots will shield you and your comforters from the fire.
Shield us from the fire?
Look! Light.
Orange light. Looks like a big magma chamber up ahead.
You are correct.
And we'll be safe?
Correct.
And will Benamus be there?
Correct.
Do you say anything but correct?
Trick question detected.
Okay, I'll give you that.
It's getting hot in here.
Yeah, very.
It is magma.
Remain calm. We are now passing into the magma chamber.
It's so bright.
Yep.
I can barely see anything.
Just keep following Floaty over there.
Correct. Please follow me.
Is that another cave?
Oh, looks like an alcove dug out of the chamber wall. It's enormous, shielded from the magma. It has tubes coming out of it.
Correct. Venomoth will be there, awaiting you, Chosen.
Okay.
Can we keep going with him?
Negative. You are not the Chosen. You are not permitted to meet Venomoth. You must turn back now. Your mission is over.
Please, let them come with me.
Negative. I cannot allow them to meet Venomoth. They are not the Chosen.
Wait a minute. Chosen? Who made the choice?
Venomoth.
Did Venomoth ask him, or any of the others, if they wanted to do this before he chose them?
Negative.
And Ben's word is final, yeah?
Correct.
TikTok?
Oh, now I really want to talk to Ben.
You cannot.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'll have you know that I was chosen for something just as important as this. I was never asked. I was never given the option to say no. And that, that is really not okay. Come on. I've got something to say to him.
TikTok?
You just...
I deactivated it. If I like what Ben tells me, I might turn it back on. Now, come on.
Whoa! What the...
Go figure. It's not a god. It's a machine.
A machine? Whoa. It's big.
You. The one referred to as TikTok.
Yes. Hello, Ben. The doctor will see you now.
You assaulted one of my drones. Explain your intentions.
I wanted to talk to you, and it was getting in the way.
This is an act of aggression.
Oh my gosh. Look,
that's... That's the previous Chosen!
What? Yes. Looks like the hooked up to the machine and feeding it life. Alrighty, Benamos. Tell me, what are you?
I am Benamos, a benevolent enforcement and material oversight system.
And your primary function?
To observe the evolution of life on this world and report to my creators.
And who are your creators?
Data not found.
Oh, of course. Why is that Kazi plugged into you? I? What's the point? She hasn't aged by the looks of it, still.
My primary fusion reactors have suffered significant heat damage. While waiting for repairs, I have had to use the energy of native life forms, what you refer to as magic, to maintain power.
So, it was all a lie?
Oh, I think I see. The locals see you as a god. A sleeping god. You must have gone into stasis for a while to preserve power. And then, when they came to you for help curing a disease, you cured them. But, in exchange, you demanded life. You learned that they look up to you, revere you, and you needed a way to bring them to you to feed that battery of yours. Hence the pipes.
Those tubes connect to something up there. It's glowing.
Liquid Arcanium.
Oh, right. Arcanium. The substance with the most powerful known reaction to magic. Incredibly sensitive stuff. Highly reactive. Pumping some of it into the magma.
TikTok? What did he do?
He caused the volcanic eruptions. Didn't ya, Ben?
Correct.
Hey, it's okay. You're going to be fine.
Well, that just won't do, will it?
I must continue my mission.
No, you must not. The smart thing to do right now would be to shut yourself down and leave these innocent people alone before you make me any angrier.
I must continue my mission. Bring me the Chosen.
Tentacles!
Give me the Chosen.
Ah, help me!
Do not interfere.
Oh, I'm gonna interfere. Mito, tell me, do you want to be here? Do you want to be the Chosen? Do you want to have a choice?
I don't want to be here. I want to go home.
You have no choice.
Ben, I am going to ask you to shut up and let me finish talking. Lyra, take Mito back to the surface right now.
Huh? Well, what about you?
I'm going to make sure that Mito gets a choice.
Okay, come on, Mito. Let's get out of here.
You are not a pony.
Took you a while to figure that one out, didn't it?
What are you?
Wrong question. It's who?
Who are you?
Well, you sure you want to know?
Who are you?
I am someone who is lost between two worlds. Someone who is never given a choice, never asked. I am someone who has had everything ripped so far apart that I am all but a different person. I wasn't even sure I liked who I turned into. But I am also someone who can now make that choice. Someone who will not stand by and watch another child have their life ruined by a god from the stars, just like mine was. And so, Benamos, I am the Doctor, and you are done.
No, I must continue my mission. If you are telling the truth, you will be a suitable substitute. You are now the Chosen.
Oh, bugger off. My screwdriver!
You are the Chosen. Do not resist.
Let go of me, you stupid little...
Oh. Do not resist.
Victor!
Lyra! What are you...
Saving your life.
Do not interfere.
Shut!
Oh! Ow!
Quit fighting and get up!
What?
What did you do to him?
I kicked him.
Wow. Never underestimate the power of a well-placed block. Huh. Marvelous. Wait, where's Mito?
Back in the tunnels, heading for the surface. We were being chased by drones for a second, but then they said something about targets changing and backed off.
Ah. He decided I would be the chosen instead. Looks like you kicked him into a reboot. He isn't actually totally stopped.
Is he gonna wake up?
Nah. I just need a little bit here to turn him off.
Wait, but what about the Kazi that's plugged into him?
Unfortunately, she's going to die. Plugged into Ben here for as long as she has been, she's entirely dependent on him. Turning him off is basically cutting off her life support.
Oh. Isn't there something you can do for her?
I am. I'm putting her out of this misery. Whoa!
Turn it back on!
Systems restored. Warning. Graspers inoperable. Deploying drones.
That's bad. Lyra, we need to run!
Over there! Tunnel!
Maintenance shaft, I would guess. Come on!
Drones deployed.
There's a lot of them!
Trust me, I noticed! Need a way out of this. Need a way out of this. Oh, come on. Come on. Aha! Over there! Door! Let's go!
Okay, are we safe?
That answer your question?
Yes, it does!
Good. I can't hold this door closed forever, so see if you can find a way out of this room.
All right. Okay. It's just a storage room. There's a lot of boxes, but no way out.
Well, that's problematic. What are in the crates?
I don't know how to open this thing.
Well, push some buttons then!
Okay. Let's see here. Whoa! Hey, TikTok! These crates are full of arcanium, I think.
Say what?
Yeah, they're blue and glowing, just like the tubes we saw outside.
Oh, that's actually really helpful.
Really?
Yep. On the count of five, I am going to stop blocking this door and get out of the way. When I do, I want you to chuck that crate of arcanium at the drones as they come in.
Wait, what? Arcanium's really reactive to magic. What if we get caught in the blast?
It's a pretty small crate, so we should be fine. But I'll close the door after you chuck it, if I can. Now, are you ready?
Okay.
Okay. Five. Four.
If this doesn't work, then...
Three.
I'm sorry, Bon Bon.
Two. One.
Alert. Arcanium crystal spill detected in maintenance corridor 159.
Tick the walls.
Uh-oh. He has more pipes filled with the stuff on the walls. Hang on, Lyra. There are about to be a lot of explosions.
You said it was a small box.
They always end up bigger on the...
Oh, I'm gonna beat the...
Warning. Critical damage in numerous sectors. Catastrophic arcanium leaks. Immediate maintenance required. My mission must continue. My mission must continue. My mission must continue.
Ahem.
Are we alive?
I think so. I mean, unless hell is a dusty caved-in storage closet with a green unicorn for company.
Can you save the snark, please, for like 5 minutes?
Sorry. Whew. Post-adrenaline high. Now, we need to get out of here. Look around.
Do you think Benimos is still alive?
Considering all the explosions that just went off, I should bloody well hope not.
Well, yeah, but he's huge.
Lyra, take a listen for a sec. Do you hear that?
Hear what?
Exactly. Big machines like to make humming noises all the time. Maybe it's their fans or reactors or turbines, doesn't matter. Point is, big mechanical things make a lot of noise, especially when you're in their guts. Right now, not a peep. So I am at least, 80% sure that he is out for the count.
Oh, all right. Well, I'll take your word for it and hope you're right.
Ditto. Now, let's get out of here. That wall there looks cracked.
Yeah, and I think I can see the glow of the lava.
Alrighty then. Stand back, Lyra. I got this.
Huh?
Hi-ya! And that's how you do it. Ah, come on. Let's get, out of...
Oh, those are the locals. Do you think they're mad at us?
Maybe, just let me do the talking.
Wait, look. Is that Muto?
What? Oh, so it is.
There they are! Those are the ponies who saved me!
But... what in the blazes am I looking at? What is this thing? Where is Benimos?
Hello. Right. So, Benimos is right here.
What? What are you talking about?
If you're telling the truth, you killed the sleeping god! Now we're all gonna burn!
No, no! We're not! Listen to me, please! Benimos, he's not a god. He's a machine. And he was the one causing the eruptions.
He was doing it because he needed energy. Life force. Magic. He got it whenever a chosen came down as a sacrifice.
And he tried to kill us when we found out, but, well, now he can't hurt you anymore. The volcanoes aren't going to be erupting like that anymore.
For over 1,000 years, Benimos has been the center of our culture. If he's gone, and if it was all a lie, then what are we supposed to do?
Well, the way I see it, you can just live your lives. Now, without fear of big volcanic eruptions or of having things forced on you by something from the stars.
We have a great deal to think about. What are your names, both of you?
I'm Lyra Heartstrings.
And I am the Doctor.
Doctor who?
Just the Doctor.
Very well. Lyra Heartstrings, Doctor, I must ask that the both of you leave our town. We have much to ponder, and no offense, I think it would be for the best if we did so without you here.
We understand. We were probably going to head out after all this anyway.
Very well.
Excuse me. Pardon me. Coming through.
Huh?
Mom?
Mito, I'm so glad you're okay.
Mom.
Doctor? Lyra?
Yes?
Do you mind if we walk with you for a while? We have a lot to say.
That we do.
What do you think, Lyra? This is your adventure, after all.
Sure. We'd be glad for the company. We have a funky blue box a ways outside of town. We'd be happy to have you until we get there.
Yep. What she said.
Funky blue box?
Well, then please be on your way.
All right. Come on. I'll lead the way.
Right behind you.
Again, I cannot thank you enough for saving our son. To think it was all a lie told by a machine.
You're welcome. Although, what about the festival? This was kind of a big deal in your culture, wasn't it?
It was. But it only came up every 100 years or so. Whenever someone was chosen, we'll manage.
The festival can still happen, maybe every year now, to celebrate the ponies who showed us the truth.
Maybe. We'll see how things go.
Oh, is that your box?
Yep, that's my box. It may not look like it, but it is a fully functional spaceship. It's how we got here.
It's kinda small.
Eh, not really.
What?
Hang on a second. Mito, before Lyra and I go, you want to see something awesome?
Oh? Something awesome? Like what?
The inside of my marvelous ride.
Is marvelous just your catchphrase now?
Might be.
Sure! Open it up, open it up! Whoa! It's...
what's going on? What is it?
Let the kid have his little moment of wonder. No grown-ups allowed.
You are an odd one. You know that?
I am well aware.
And you're being nice for a change.
I had some motivation to get my act together.
It's incredible! It's bigger on the inside!
I love it when they say that.
What?
Oh, never you mind. Now then, we should be off.
Wait. Here. I want you to have my scarf as thanks for saving me.
Oh? Oh, I really don't think...
Please, mister. It's the least I can do to say thank you. For everything.
I don't know.
Oh, go on. It looked good on you. Besides, you look cold.
I suppose. Thank you very much, Mito. I'll take good care of it for you. I promise.
You'd better. He sewed that scarf himself.
Oh, no. I won't let it get damaged. I swear it. Now, with that, we must now bid you adieu. Lyra, hop on in. I'll be with you in a second.
Right. But first, Mito, can I hug you? I never got to say it earlier, but you are adorable.
Yes, please.
All right, let us get in on that.
Come on in.
Oh, our little boy.
Okay, I guess I'll go in first. Wow,
What? You don't like making kids happy? You're not a tourist trap. You're a TARDIS. And a damn rambunctious one at that. Ow! Did you just hit me on the head with one of the screens? Really? Oi.
Woo! All right! I feel great! Okay, so where to next, TikTok?
Don't call me TikTok. The TARDIS brought us here so I could make my choice. And I have. I am the Doctor.
Well, that's good to know. Are you going to go on more adventures?
Probably. But first, I need to drop you off at home. You still have a girlfriend waiting for you, don't you?
Yes, I do. Does this mean I won't be coming with you?
I'd love it if you did. If you can convince Bon Bon to come with you, then sure. But I don't want to get in the way of your relationship if she doesn't want to.
Don't worry. I'm sure I can convince her.
Means. I'll be in here and, personalize things a bit.
Okay. Don't you go anywhere, Doctor. I'll be right back.
All right. Let's see what... Wait. 10 days? Oh. Oops.
This has been Doctor Whooves Living Legacy, Episode 3, The Mantle, written by Toneshift and Tom117Z. Kuvan, Mito's father, Benamos, and one of the guards were all voiced by Toneshift. TikTok and one of the crowd members were voiced by Geeky Sonic. Lyra Heartstrings was voiced by Kenzie VA. The other crowd member and the voice of the TARDIS were played by Anna Melody. Vimat and Mito were both played by Snivy G. Absol. Mito's mother was played by Lumina Starlight. Guard 2 was played by Tom117Z. Most of the music in this audio production come from the official Doctor Who soundtrack, whereas various others came from sources such as Radiark, Epidemic Sound, Nier Automata, and potentially others. Most of the sounds for this project come from freesound.org or were pulled directly from the Doctor Who TV show. Doctor Who is owned by the BBC, while My Little Pony: Friendship is Magic is owned by Hasbro and DHX Media. This is a fan-made project, made with nothing but love and passion for both franchises, with no copyright infringement intended, and no profits made whatsoever. Please support the official release of both franchises. Thank you very much for tuning in and listening, people, and we'll see you next time.